Hey, my name is Nadir Omowale, and today we're going to set up the QCon Pro G2 and QCon EX G2 MIDI DAW controllers from iCon Pro Audio. Now, before you set up your QCons with your DAW, please make sure to register your new devices on our website, iconproaudio.com. While you're there, please download the latest IMAP software and upgrade to the latest firmware. In this case, it is version 1.02. We're on the Mac today, so we're gonna pull up the audio MIDI setup to make sure that the latest firmware is selected in our devices. Now, if you happen to see a previous version of the firmware, please erase and remove that so your control surface communicates properly with your computer when you power on. For this video, we happen to be using Logic Pro as our digital audio workstation. If you have another DAW, your steps are going to be just a little bit different, but most of the concepts are the same, so this video will still help you out. New in the QCon Pro Generation 2 is a simplified and more powerful DAW mode setup. So there are only four modes: MCP for Mackie Control Protocol, which is going to work for most digital audio workstations; Pro Tools, which runs Mackie HUI Protocol specifically with Avid Pro Tools; Logic Pro Mode is Mackie Control, but we have to handle some of the idiosyncrasies of Apple Logic Pro just a little bit differently; and then User Defined Mode, which allows you to create your own custom MIDI mapping setups. We chose Logic Pro. If you're using another DAW, you'll use the Record Enable buttons on channel 6 and 7 to toggle through the other modes. As you can see, I'm rocking the fully expanded QCon Pro G2 system with three QCon EX extensions for 32 channels of control. And as you set up each device, you want to make sure that each extension is labeled correctly. The first extension to the left should be extension 1. The second is extension 2. The third is extension 3, as you look at the names of the extensions in the LCD screen on the QCon EX devices. Now, let's jump into Logic. We're gonna go to the Logic Pro tab and click Control Surface. Then click Setup. Next, click New. And for Mode, select Mackie Control. On my input and output ports, I want to see the QCon Pro G2. And as you can see, the faders will jump to attention to let you know that the DAW is now connected to the QCon Pro control surface and is ready for action. Now we want to create an additional Mackie device for each of our extensions. So we follow the previous steps. Go to the input output port, select the QCon EX extension 1. Extension 1 faders will now rise, indicating that this extension is connected to the DAW, and we move on to extension 2. Again, repeat the previous steps for extension 2 and for extension 3. And so now that everything is set up, we hit the play button and let's see if everything is connected properly. Look at that. We are ready to rock and roll. We hope this tutorial for the QCon Pro G2 setup has been helpful for you. Please subscribe to our channel for more tutorials. If you happen to have any additional questions, you can reach out to us at iconproaudio.com. Select the Help Center tab. You'll want to visit our community first. That's probably the quickest way to get the answers that you need right there on our website. But if you don't find an answer to your questions in the community, you can submit a request. Just input your information and submit your ticket. And one of our customer support engineers will get back to you as soon as humanly possible to answer any questions that you might have. So again, my name is Nadir. I hope this video has been helpful for you. Thank you very much for using QCon Pro Audio.